Yes, the crayons, thank you.
I gotta, I'll hold her for a minute, but then I gotta take her to try to feed her.
Oh, okay, honey, I'm sorry.
No, hold her.
Hi, sweetheart.
I'm waiting for Omar to bring my stuff in anyway.
Hello.
Hi.
You do have dark hair.
I know.
Hi, Kenny.
Hi, how you doing?
Okay, honey.
Good to see ya.
How's the Godfather this morning?
Good, very good.
Very
excited. Yeah, hey. Hi.
It's time to spring.
Look at you. Hi.
Say hi. Say hi.
The Godfather.
Yes.
That's right.
You want the Godfather to take the baby?
Oh,
and the
yeah.
Father.
You're right.
What do you want this?
Switch. Hold that.
Come here, you. Oh,
got
is this recording?
Her?
Yep.
Okay,
oh,
this is, wait a minute.
I don't know what.
don't hold her that way.
Okay, I got her.
Got her now?
Yep.
Say,
hey.
Hold me nice, Uncle
hey.
Kenny.
All right. There you go. Ooh, okay.
Now turn around to the camera.
There you go.
Yeah.
Hi.
Say hi. Aw, look at her eyes. She's got such pretty eyes.
Your big
yes,
daddy.
He does. Is that
Dada?
Is that Dada? Uh-oh. Say, come on, Mom. Say, come on, Mom. Say, come on, Mom. Say,
come on, Mom.
I'm still not used to it.
I can go feed you.
Hi, sweetie.
She's better now. She's bigger, right?
Yeah, definitely a little.
It's more solid.
Uh-huh.
Hi, yeah. Oh, I forgot those pictures I had for your mom.
Oh. Hey. Hi.
Hi.
Boy, I watch Michigan and Michigan State.
Yeah. I don't think it matters. Does it matter, Mom?
Yeah, you can hold it up. That's the back, I think.
Yes.
Facing you is the back.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
How cute you have. Ready? I know, what a neat. I know, it's so much fun.
And more to come.
Girlfriend.
How are you?
Good. How are you?
Oh,
yeah,
watch it.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that face.
Oh,
I like this. Is, let me
this
tell
feel.
You.
Oh, awesome.
Number two.
Number two.
I don't know. What is it?
It's like the quality.
Yeah. And then we'll leave the back open. Your godmother
is
going to hate you to pull it down.
How are you?
Let's see what your question is going to be.
Once she's got all those layers on.
I think she likes
that. Congratulations, everyone.
Thank you.
I had to bribe her to wear this dress.
I couldn't
do it. Just got lipstick. I wore my other cloth.
Rain is good.
Rain is
good.
Rain is always good.
Rain is good.
You know, rain follows us.
Hello. You'll see him. He looks.
Hi, Grandpa.
One more.
So I bought
no, I'll leave it open.
Hi. Hey, Joe, that's a lot of pressure.
I'm sorry.
I sweat.
She's like, you're doing a good job. Okay, she's like, I like
happy.
Is this forward?
I mean, layers.
Which way does it go, Mom?
It opens in the front.
Oh, that
in the front.
This is the back.
Yeah.
This is the third layer now.
Do you want to lay it down and I'll lift it?
Yeah. It's like a wedding gown.
I know.
It's gorgeous there.
It's so special because Danielle.
I know.
No tears.
I know.
The antique.
I didn't see the picture
it
of
is.
Danielle and her.
Oh, you have to put them together then. Yeah.
Yeah. Nancy, this is Danielle.
I know when
she
you bought that.
She wore this to be baptized in.
Your mom probably never did.
Wow.
I know.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Grandma, when you bought that,
you
never How you
doing there, stranger?
Never. Hi,
she great wrote. Grandma.
She wear a phone for the party, but she is
thank
a
thank you. I love it. Do you want this one?
Look, she's comfortable with you, Lena. It looks like...
Yeah, it doesn't
like...
How's a little girl doing?
She's a happy baby.
Oh, boy.
Pretty.
Unbelievable.
Right there. I could get this.
Is that her
hat? Yeah. And a baby. Yeah, we're not
really
going to wear the baby. It looks like too much. Yeah.
How many years ago?
Hey, look.
almost at the same, they're almost at the same age when they were both baptized. She was like the same age as Adriana is now when she was baptized.
Yeah.
Do you want Kenny to put that on? Or
yeah, Kenny.
Okay. Yep. It's already recording, just aim.
Oh, okay.
All right.
She's not paying attention.
We'll see.
Is this the back or the?
That's the back.
Okay.
Is it Danielle's Sacred Heart Church?
Yes.
Yes.
So pretty.
Aww.
Look at her looking right at you.
Uh huh.
I'll pick it up on the way out.
I don't know if I can tie that again.
Hold this one.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you move back a little that way so you're not in the queue? Yeah.
Yours will be fine.
Yeah. I'll put them on the computer and send them.
Oh, look at her feet. Yeah, because I need them too.
Oh, yeah, I have her socks.
She's like, my feet.
Oh, her socks are in the black bag. Where's Omar? Omar, where's her black bag?
What?
Her black bag?
In the car?
The car.
That has her socks in it.
Alright.
Yeah.
She has a key.
I have
a key. For sure. We're about to see new members into the body of Christ. This is exciting. This is good. What I like to do here is to have you feel extremely relaxed. Okay? Who of all these officers out there? Who's got the cameras?
You're right.
Okay. Oh my God. What will happen is the anointings will take place in the front pews. Okay, so I'll go there. So when I do go there, just gather around the front right there and take a good close-up picture. The baptism obviously takes place in the front, and I'll assemble the paparazzi up there. We'll put you guys out over here so we can get a nice close-up picture of the font and the baptism. I like to explain what we do. So if you're Catholic and you have not been to church in a while, no need to raise your hand. He raised his hand. You too young though, so don't worry about that. So anyway, this is sort of a refresher course. If you're not Catholic and you always wonder why we do what we do, here we go. We'll finally get the message, okay? We're not that unusual, no. But we have some really rich symbols. We have fire, we have water, we have oil, we have all kinds of things. And unless we really, intuitively understand and appreciate the symbols and what they mean, and what it means in the ceremony of baptism itself, then we kind of, close one ear and out the other. And I don't like to do mediocrity, so you'll have to deal with me for the next 40 minutes. I also like to play music for most of the ceremony. It kind of lends a little bit of background to our prayer service, and we are in a prayer service, by the way, so we need to respect that. But I think the music kind of helps us get us into that kind of mood, that kind of sense of prayer. Sometimes when we have two little girls today, but sometimes when we have five or six babies, okay, that gets a little bit weird because one baby will get the other baby, and before you know it, you've got a camel coming on. So sometimes with that, I'll play Gregorian chants, the best hits of the 14th century, okay? Because the babies fall asleep. It works every, some of the parents fall asleep too, but they fall asleep. So it works out quite well, so there's selfish reasons for it. But for today, we'll be doing some soft instrumental music. So if the parents are ready, and they can gather in the vestibule, and they may be there already, they know already, good. Okay, and if the, Godparents, just join me up on the top step of the altar area here, that'd be great.
I can't see.
come stand next to your chosen godparents and welcome. Today's October 8th, 2017. We're about to do something that's important in the lives of these families, but especially in the lives of these children. Today is essentially spiritual day of growth, day one. And so we begin all things in prayer. In the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit. The parents, I ask you this question. What name do you give to your child? And what do you ask the God's church for them? You're asked to have your children baptized. In doing so, you're accepting the responsibility to train them in the practice of the faith. It will be your duty to bring them up to keep God's commandments as Christ taught us by loving God and our neighbor. You clearly understand what you're undertaking. I didn't answer that question before. I'm going to keep you on edge. So, and to the godparents, I ask you this question. Are you ready to help these parents in their duty as Christian mothers and fathers?
Yes.
Good. I'd like to have you hand over the little girls over to one of the godparents right now. The reason why I like to do this is that by handing them over to the godparents actually represent all of us in the church. And so in you receiving these children, you're receiving them from all of us too. And so we honor that, and we are grateful that you are their godparents. To the children, I say this. The Church of God welcomes you with great joy. In His name, I now claim you for Christ, our Savior, by signing His cross. I will now trace the cross on your foreheads. Invite your parents and godparents to do the same.
If you would,
It's a picture that you probably see every Mother's Day and Christmas time and all. You see? Those are the pictures.
Mary.
You shy? Who's the picture? Mary and Jesus, okay. Now, what I'd like you to do on this side of the aisle, okay, is to take Jesus out of the picture and put her here, being held by your Heavenly Mother. Changes the dynamic, doesn't it? Standing over here. Think about the apple. Put it in. Put her into the place where Jesus was. So all the days that are recorded in the book, we pray that there will be many, many decades to come. And just give us a thought. There's a good chance that these two little girls will live deep into the next century. That's a sobering thought, isn't it? So, given that truth and that reality, rather than just being her name or their names in the book, we're going to put them on a DVD or a Blu-ray. And their life story will be recorded. Everything will be recorded. Every mountaintop experience will be there. Every day when maybe things weren't so great, we'll be there too. All of this. The question now becomes, what are you going to contribute to the story? Teach these girls. You have a part in it? All of us do. What will you contribute to make this story work? So that eventually, when they get to go home again, they'll say, this is my story, I'm sticking to it. The best I can do with what I have. The best that they can do with what they have. The best for to be what we can give them to be the best. So how does this happen? So I'm going to use a simple point. You can't use your imagination. A baseball. What does a baseball have to do with baptism? Everything. See, I wanted to be first baseman for the New York Mets, but Keith Hernandez went up getting my job. Yeah. And when they say you can't hit the curveball in high school, you don't go too far. So, but baseball. Years ago, I used to work for Dell Publishing. And at that time, back in the 80s, they published Billy Martin's autobiography. Billy Martin, for some of you who don't know, was the rather unusual manager of the New York Yankees for about five times. And in between jobs that he kept getting fired from the Yankees, he wrote his autobiography, which I don't think he wrote. He probably never wrote a letter, okay? But I think he dictated to sports writer wrote it down, and Billy wrote his book number one. So, the situation was he said some rather uncharitable things about George Steinbrenner, the owner of the Yankees back then, who was always in the papers. George Steinbrenner heard about this, calls up Billy, and says, hey, listen, I hear you got a book coming out, and you're saying bad things about it. He says, listen, why don't you just take that stuff out of there? So Billy's probably getting to himself, I'm probably going to work for George at some point in the future. So he calls up the publishers who I used to work for and says, listen, those books about Steinbrenner, why don't you just, spread them out? To which the editor says, we can't do that. It doesn't work that way. Billy drew a book. You wrote it. It's the way it works. We just trust it's the truth. Whatever happens between you and George, you know, not ours. We just published the book. He says, no, it's not going to work that way. So a big lawsuit ensued. Obviously, right? No, he's good. Part of the promotion of the book was that Billy would show up at the Britannias, the Barnes & Nobles, the Borders, and all the stores, and sign the book, and also give out a baseball to the kids who would come. And so as a result of the lack of promotion, they let it be also to be a promoting factor. The promotion never happened. Never wound up going to the stores and never gave out the balls. So I got called by one of the people at the office and said, listen, we got to get rid of these baseballs. He took me to a room and there was baseball from St. Joseph over to the window over there, all the way up the wall. Grosses and grosses of baseball. Why? Because they were supposed to be given out. This was the supply they had. He says, we need the space, you got to get somebody here to throw them out. And I says, why are we going to throw baseballs out? I says, if I get a guy who runs a little league, do you care? He said, I don't care, we can do it. Just get him out of here within 2 weeks. So, called this guy who runs a little league. He comes in that following Saturday, sees all these baseballs there. Okay? He has about five or six of the little leaguers with him. They caught the balls after him in the pickup truck and clean all day long. This guy just died in his life. He has enough baseballs to stock his league for the next 20 years. Something happened. Later that week, because he used to work in the same company with me. He shows up with a box for his ball. And he says, Jim, there's something wrong with the balls you gave me. I said, what do you mean there's something wrong? He says, they went bad. I said, baseballs don't go bad. They're not fruit, okay? That doesn't make any sense. What do you mean by that? He says, take a look. He opens up the box, and there's egg-shaped balls. One had a dent in it, a real severe dent. I says, wow, this is unbelievable. You mean they came out of a box like this, all of them? He says, no. We were doing batting practice the other night, and the kids were hitting them. And they were breaking the balls, they were busting them up, and they were misshaping things after they hit them. I said, and this is, don't forget, these kids are 12 years old, this before steroids. How strong could they possibly be? So, I get the maintenance guy to come up with a big knife, exacto type knife, and so I said, look, cut into this thing, there's something wrong with these balls. So he rips into it, and we had the horse side stitching, all of that. Then inside, there is the yarn. You know, anybody knows about a baby, it's yarn, tightly wound. And so the main guy is digging deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper, and all of a sudden he comes to the middle. He finds out, he sees that there's something black in there. He says, I said, wait, look at that. There's no core. Anybody knows anything about a baseball, it says there should be a core. When you go cheap, go rubber, the cork is better. There's no core in it. So essentially what this thing was not meant to be used for in a game at all. It was only meant to be signed by Billy, put on a shelf, so some grandkid can come by 30 years later, take it off and sell it on eBay and get maybe 40 bucks for the thing, okay? That was the whole idea. So, but there's something else about it as well, and that's what struck me about baptism, is this. Today, you are essentially parents and godparents. What you're saying is that for the beginning of today, with this sacrament of baptism, you are claiming for these children, these little girls of yours, that they are going to be anchored in Christ, that Christ will be their core. You see? These balls are nothing but well-covered yarn. That's all they were. That's why they got banged up so easy, nothing melted together. The Christ is the core of these children's lives, the central of hope. And whatever comes in their life, that may be those moments when things are not going great, they'll have the strength to be able to weather the storm, continue onward, because they got Christ with them, in them, not just with them, in them, from this day forward. So that eventually, when the first communion time comes, confirmation time comes, Christ will not be some figure on a cross, some statue. Christ will be alive in their heart. And that's when we begin with baptism. But just because you're born in a baby does not make you a dump, does it? Okay? You need to be nurtured in the faith. And with this, the challenge for all the parents and godparents, and all the extended family too, is to nurture the children in the faith so that Christ is not a mystery. Christ is not some figure from history, but Christ is the real essence of who they are. And with that, they will continue. So that eventually, they will get to go home again. And it'll all work out just fine. Let's continue in prayer. So I guess you won't be looking at a baseball quite the same anymore, will you? As Catholic Christians, we believe what we call prayers of intercession, but that simply is that we pray for one another, and so we pray for these children and for all of us here. My brothers and sisters, let us ask our Lord Jesus Christ to lovingly on these children, who are to be baptized on their parents and godparents, and all of us. By the mystery of your death and resurrection, may these children in life give them the new life of baptism and welcome them into your own church. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. Through baptism and confirmation, make them your faithful follower and witness to your gospel. Lord, hear our prayer. Lead them by a whole life to the joys of God's kingdom. Lord, hear our prayer. Make the lives of their parents and godparents examples of faith to inspire these children. Lord, hear our prayer. Keep their families always in your love. Lord, hear our prayer. Renew the grace of our baptism in each one of us here today. Lord, hear our prayer. As Catholic Christians, we believe in what we call the community of saints. That simply means that over the course of the past 2,000 years, there have been people who have done the very best they could to live the life according to what Christ called them to live. And we can eventually call them saints. And so we ask them to come into this building, this church, to pray for these two girls. Christ. St. Peter and St. Paul, pray for us. All holy men and women, pray for us. I'd like to ask you to invite into this church today all the members of your own family, fathers, mothers, grandparents, aunts, uncles, godparents, that have already gone on to their heavenly reward, but they would be here celebrating with you today if they could be here. So spiritually, we invite them into this space to pray for these children as well. So think of those folks right now. To the little ones, we anoint you with the oil of salvation in the name of Christ our Savior. May he strengthen you with his power, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. I'd like to ask the young ones to come up and help me flush the water. The young ones out there. Those two guys out there, come on up. And I baptized those guys already, so they're used to it. Little ones out there, little ones out there. Run them up, you can come up too. Where do you want to begin? Oh, back here, come on up.
This is scary.
Amen.
Good. Amen. No, she's awake.
Photographers over here. Great.
anoint with the oil of chrism. The purpose of this is to, now they are baptized, they literally are. So now we're sending them forth. Now they're going to be with you for a few years, right? In some cases, 10 days. Okay. But regardless, okay, the situation is that now they have received Christ and are empowered by Christ through the Spirit. And so this oil here is meant to be a sign of empowerment to send them forth, so that throughout the course of their lives, that they would be willing to profess their faith as well and not be shy about Christ. So we pray this prayer for that. God the Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you from sin. He's given you the birth by the word of the Holy Spirit. He's welcomed you with his holy people. Now I want you, in the prison of salvation, as Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so you may live always as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. I'm going to say that again. Like that last line. So may you, little girls and little boys, may you always live as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life. That's a long time. Everlasting life is long. And so we're grateful that we can do this. So we do this for little girls. And for this, I need to anoint the top of the head. Light it up. Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. These children of yours have been enlightened by Christ. They are to walk always as children of the light. May they keep the flame of faith alive in their hearts. When the Lord comes to meet with, may they meet with him and with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. Amen. May blow them out. I hope this is a challenge for you. Today is October the 8th, right? Okay, so next year, October 8th, get the candles out. Get yourself some funny bones or something like that. And stick it in there and have yourself a spiritual birthday party for yourself, okay? Now, if you take me up with you, do it every year, okay, on October 8th. You burn the candles out, don't see me, I'll get you another candle. So, we have a lot of candles right there. We're a church. We have a lot of candles. The last anointing that we'll be doing is called the Don't Hear the Prayer of Heaven, called the Ears and the Mouth. Don't worry, I'll use this one here. The purpose of this one is to be a sign of being bold in the faith. Now, one day you'll bring Jesus with his friend who's walking along the street, and then you'll have somebody who could not hear, could not speak. And so Jesus anointed his ears, and at that moment he was able to hear for the first time. And he anointed his mouth, which that is able to speak. So just think of the miracle of that moment for that man who could not hear and could not speak. Now the whole world is open to him. So if these children here, we believe the whole world is being open to them as well. So we anoint the ears, we anoint the mouth, we anoint the prayer for effort. In Aramaic, the Aramaic language, which is the language Jesus spoke, the effort of the word means to be open. And so for these little girls, I say this. The Lord Jesus made the deaf to hear and dumb to speak. He stood such an ears to receive his word. And your mouth to proclaim his faith, to praise the glory of God the Father. Amen.
So they'll join my club here, my group,
So, but I have an easy job. I just get to pray for them. You get to pay the bills. And when college comes around, they're old enough to learn about the Bible. Who knows what that price is going to be. Really, yeah, seriously. But it's an honor to do this. It's a privilege to do it, and I'm grateful that I have the opportunity to share this time with you. Typically, all these children have been reborn in baptism. They are now called children of God, and so indeed they are. In confirmation, they will receive the fullness of God's Spirit. In Holy Communion, they will share the banquet of Christ's sacrifice, calling God their Father in the midst of the Church. In their name, in the Spirit of our common sonship and daughtership, let us pray together the glory of the Lord has given to us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be
thy kingdom come. Thy will be done.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Let's have a mom who's come forward without your children. Mom. Say a prayer of blessing for you. God the Father, through His Son, the Virgin Mary, His child, the joy of all Christian mothers. As they see the hope of eternal life shine on their children, may you bless the mothers of these children. They now thank God for the gift of their children. May they be one with them and thank Him forever in heaven. Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May you be blessed. Let the dad please come forward. God is the giver of all life, human and divine. May he bless the children of, may he bless the father of these children. And with their mothers, they will be the first to achieve of the teachers of the children in the ways of faith. May they also be the best of teachers, bearing witness to faith by what they say and do. In Christ Jesus our Lord, amen.
Hi. Pretty girl.